Hello students, welcome back to the new session wherein we will discuss about the relative velocity method of finding velocity and acceleration of the given mechanism. Okay, so let us consider the first problem. The given problem is PQRS in a 4-bar chain with link PSS fixed. Okay, PQRS is a 4-bar chain with link PS fixed. So the length of the links are given here. PQ is equal to 62.5 millimeter, QR 175 millimeter, RS 112.5 millimeter, and PSS 200 millimeter. The crank PQ rotates at 10 radians per second clockwise. So draw the velocity and acceleration diagram when angle QPS is equal to 60 degree. Q and R lie on the same side of PS. Find the angular velocity and angular acceleration of links QR and RS. So this is the given question. So we have already discussed about the relative velocity method, okay, wherein we find velocity of a link with respect to or relative to another link. Okay, so here, very first thing is, we know that. So crank PQ rotates at 10 radians per second. So directly he has given the omega. So omega PQ or QP is equal to 10 radians per second. Okay, so when you have omega or angular velocity, you can find out the linear velocity, correct? So the velocity of QP, velocity of QP or velocity of Q with respect to P, okay, is given in terms of omega QP into R. R is nothing but the link length. R is nothing but the link length, that is PQ. That is 10 into PQ is given as 62.5 millimeter or 0.0625 meters. Okay, so using this, you can find out the velocity QP. So QP 0.0625. Okay, is the link length PQ. So that is equal to 0.625 meter per second. The answer for the velocity of Q with respect to P is 0.625 meter per second. Now, once you find the velocity, okay, magnitude of the velocity, so you can draw the velocity diagram. So before that, we need to draw the space diagram or the configuration diagram. And space diagram, as you people know, is drawn using the original dimensions given. Correct. So here you can take any scale of your choice, no problem. okay. So in configuration diagram, there is no need for scale as the values or the dimensions from the diagram are not used for the construction of velocity or the acceleration diagrams. Okay. So whatever the scale you want, you can take and you can draw the configuration diagram. Okay. So let us draw the configuration diagram. Draw the fixed link PS. Then QPS is given as 60 degree. So measure 60, draw a line of the given dimension. Then using all the values, take the compass, cut the arcs and draw the configuration diagram. Okay, and draw the configuration diagram. Fine. Now, we have to draw the velocity diagram. First, consider the link PQ or the crank. So crank is rotating at 10 radians per second, uniformly at 10 radians per second. So the velocity vector will act perpendicular to that link, correct? The velocity vector will act perpendicular to that link. In the theory, we have discussed about this already. So mark a point PS, which refers to the fixed link PS. Okay, now draw a line of known magnitude. That is, see, we have found out VQP, correct? We have found out VQP, that is 0.625 meter per second. Now we have to take a scale for this. Correct. We have to take a scale for this. So what we'll do is we'll consider 0.1 meter per second as 1 centimeter. Okay, 0.1 meter per second as 1 centimeters. So, so 0.1 meter per second is equal to 1 centimeter. So draw a line, okay, parallel to the line drawn perpendicular to PQ. Okay, so this represents the velocity of Q with respect to P. And because because the crank is moving in clockwise direction. Okay, the sense or the direction of this velocity vector will be, okay, towards Q. Towards Q. Now consider the next link, that is the coupler QR. Okay, so the velocity vector acts exactly perpendicular to it, correct? So now draw a line which represents VRQ, that is velocity of R with respect to Q. So now draw a parallel line to that from Q of unknown magnitude. We don't know the magnitude. We have not found out VRQ. So draw a line of unknown magnitude. So now, so this represents V. See, the sense may be upwards or downwards. We don't know exactly about that because, see, there is no omega given for this. Okay, we don't know the angular velocity. So therefore, so draw a line which makes sense. That is, if I draw a line downwards, it will not make sense. But if I draw a line upwards, so this will meet a line drawn from PS for the next link. So now, so similarly, find out the velocity vector for RS, that is velocity of R with respect to S. So what we have to do is we have to draw a perpendicular line to that. Okay, and same line will be drawn in the velocity diagram. Parallel to that, we need to draw a line in the velocity diagram. So this is VRS. So either in the forward direction or in the backward direction. But here, if you draw in the backward direction, it does not make any sense. So draw it in the forward direction and mention that as VRS. VRS. Okay, so this completes the velocity diagram. Now we can find out the velocities by measuring each one of them. Okay, by measuring each one of them, we can find out the respective velocities. Okay. So what we'll do is we'll find out and measure and find out what are the values of these velocities. So therefore, VQP is already found out and it is 0.625. Okay, 0.625 meter per second. Okay, now measure VRQ. So when you measure that, so it is around let us check it out. So it is around 3.2, maybe 3.3. Yeah. So 3.2 into 0.1. So that will be equal to 0.32 meter per second. Similarly, find out the value of VRS also. So VRS comes 4.4 centimeter multiplied with 0.1. So that will be 0.44 meter per second. So we have found out all the values of velocities. Now, the next step is to draw the acceleration diagrams. Draw the acceleration diagram for the given mechanism. So we know the acceleration is divided again into R. The acceleration has two components. One is radial centripetal component, radial or centripetal component, or normal component. Another one is the tangential component. Okay, so we are going to draw the acceleration diagram with the use of these two components for all the links. So let us consider each one of the link and let us find out the. So first of all, consider link QP. So for link QP, again, we have two components, radial component, AR of QP, and tangential component, AT of QP. So radial component can be found out by using the formula V square. Okay, V square QP divided by the link length QP. So we know V square, what is V? VQP? VQP is 0.625 meter per second. So square of that divided by the link length. Okay, so what is the link length of QP? It is 0.0625 meters. So use your calculator and find out the values. It will be equal to 6.25 meter per second square. Okay, but here one more thing you need to consider. So in order to find out tangential acceleration for the given crank, Okay, you need alpha, that is angular acceleration. But here, angular acceleration is zero. So therefore, AT of QP will also be zero. And therefore, AR of QP or radial component of acceleration for the linked QP will be equal to the resultant acceleration. Okay, that is, there is no AT of QP. Hence, AQP, that is resultant acceleration, is equal to 6.25 meter per second square. Now let us consider next link. Okay, so that is RQ. So ARQ, or the radial component of acceleration for the link RQ, will be given by V square RQ divided by RQ. So we know V square R, that is VRQ, that is 0.32 meter per second. So square of that divided by the link length, that is 0.175, will give you the answer 0.5851 meter per second square. And tangential acceleration for the link RQ can be found out using the acceleration diagram. Okay, so that we will do. Okay, further. So we have to find out AT of RQ. Now let us consider the next link or the last link, RS. So again, RS will have two components of acceleration, AR of RS and AT of RS. So AR of RS can be calculated using the formula V square RS divided by the link length RS. So V square RS, as you know, it is 0.44 meter per second. So 0.44 whole square divided by RS value as 0.1125. So use your calculator and find out the values. So the value obtained will be, one point seven two zero meter per second square. So we need to find out AT of RS, because alpha is unknown. We need to find out using the acceleration diagram. Now we need to take the scale. So highest value here. So consider the highest value. Highest value here is 6.25 meter per second square. So what we'll do is 1 meter per second square is equal to 1 centimeter. Let us consider the scale as 1 meter per second square is equal to 1 centimeter. Okay. So that. So mark two points, P dash, S dash. Okay, that is the fixed link points, P dash, S dash. So in the velocity diagram, mark it as PS. Okay, and use small letters to denote the remaining points. Here, use dashes. So the, once again, we'll go back and we will see. See, always, as we have discussed in the theory class or theory session, the radial component of acceleration acts along the link or parallel to the link or towards the direction of rotation or towards the direction of the point of rotation. Here point of rotation is P. Okay, and the link is PQ. So obviously it will act parallel to the link PQ. It will act parallel to the link PQ. Okay, so take your set square. Exactly draw a parallel line to the link PQ and the measured value will be 6.25. We will slow down here so that you can understand very clearly what exactly we are doing. So 1 meter per second square is equal to 1 centimeter. So 6.25 meter per second square will be equal to 6.25 centimeters. Okay, so let us draw a line for 6.25 centimeters and mark it as radial component of acceleration for the length PQ. Radial component of acceleration for the link PQ, that is Q with respect to P. Or we can also say that this is the resultant acceleration because there is no alpha. Okay, now let us move on to the next link, RQ. Okay, so radial component acts parallel to the link, correct? So we have to draw a parallel line for that, and tangential component acts perpendicular to the link. Correct? So we have to draw parallel to that. So first let us draw radial component of acceleration for the link QR. So, and we know the value for that. So that is around 0.7. Okay. And let us mark it as, or show it as AR of AR of Q RQ. AR of RQ. Now, the tangential component acts exactly perpendicular to H, correct? So, in the direction of the velocity vector, let us say, in the direction of the velocity vector. So, draw a perpendicular line. From here, draw a perpendicular line for unknown magnitude. For unknown magnitude. We don't know the magnitude, but we know the direction. That's it. Okay, we don't know the magnitude. So, now, let us consider. So, let us show that as AT of RQ. AT of RQ. Now, let us consider the third link or the final link. That is RS. Okay. So, the radial component acts along the link itself. Draw a parallel line. Okay. From S dash, draw a parallel line of known magnitude. Of known magnitude. That is equal to so 1.7. So yes, it is 1.720 maybe. So let us draw that for 1.7. So let it be AR of R with respect to yes, that is the radial component of acceleration of R with respect to yes. Now the tangential component will act perpendicular to the line or perpendicular to the link. So draw a perpendicular to this line. Okay, draw a perpendicular to this line. Wherever it intersects the AT of RQ, wherever it, and this line is denoted as AT of RS. So wherever it intersects AT of RQ, okay, so now we have got a point and we can join these two points in order to get the resultant acceleration of RQ. Resultant acceleration of RQ. So, and now join those two points in order to get the resultant acceleration of RS. Okay, you can denote them as ARS. So, how to know the signs? How to know the signs or how to know the direction of the acceleration? So, as you can see here, AR and RS are moving along same direction, correct? Are moving along same direction. So, AR plus AT will be equal to the resultant acceleration. So, therefore, that will be acting in the opposite direction. Similar, it is same for all the other mechanisms also, not only for four bar chain, but for all the mechanisms. If AR and AT are along the same direction, so the resultant acceleration will be in the opposite direction. The resultant acceleration will be in the opposite direction. Okay, so this completes the problem here. So now we need to find out some of the unknown values. So using this acceleration diagram, what we can do is we can find out the unknown values. Okay, so that's what we will do now. So first of all, find out AT of RQ or measure AT of RQ and measure AT of RS also. So AT of RQ, when you measure, it will come around 3.8 centimeters. That is equal to 3.8 meter per second square. So similarly, measure AT of RS. So that is equal to 4.8 centimeter. Or when you convert that into meter per second, so as the scale taken is 1 meter per second square is equal to 1 centimeter, you can directly write it as 4.8 meter per second square. So now find out alpha QR, that is angular acceleration of Q with respect to R. Okay, that is equal to AT of RQ divided by RQ. This is the formula which we have, correct? So that is equal to 3.8, which we have obtained from the acceleration diagram, divided by the link length of RQ. So that is 0.175. So when you calculate it using the calculator, you will find the values 21.71 radian per second square. So next, you can find out, similarly, you can find out alpha RS. So alpha RS is equal to AT of RS divided by the link length RS. So AT of RS is 4.8 meter per second square. So divided by 0.1125, it will give you some other value. Please calculate that. Okay. And please make a correction. Okay, please make a correction. So this is how we need to find out the velocity and acceleration of the given, okay, mechanism using relative velocity methods. Using relative velocity method. So in the next video or in the next session, we will discuss about another problem based on the same method, that is the relative velocity method, used in order to find velocity and acceleration of a given slider crank mechanism. Given slider crank mechanism. Thank you, students. Thank you for now.